We're going down in the tube station at midnight. The distant echo of faraway voices calling on faraway trains to take them home to the ones that they love and who love them forever. Change and pull out the queen. Standing big daddy, I'll put you the money and pull out your thumb behind me. I'll push me through the shadows, not facing voices. I felt a fist and then a kick. I could not smell their breath. They smelled top pots and wellness crops to get it right with this. All I spun around me took a look at it around me and saw that existence. That's not a problem ever.
Calling the hotel.
Which one?
Oh, I don't know. That one down in the water, somewhere down there. Still, talked to some people. They had a good time. Here is something new. The Elitist just came in a while ago and said that they made the cover. They were on the very Elitist Enemy a while ago, and they've recently made Melody Maker, and Lord Wisdom, back from England, also speaks highly of them. And he will be with us in 2 weeks' time with some goodies that he brought back. How do you describe Scritti Politti? I don't... what words could you use? Polemical funk? Maybe. Faithless? A hymn? An anthem?
Thank you.
Lost, gritty, politi, faithless, faithless, faithless friends. 12 inches, faithless, the irreverent Johann Bruno. Friends and techno peasants, lend me your fears. Across God's country, I am here to quell your fears and tears. Let there be none, for this is Sunday morning. Oh, Canada, oh, Mother Core. Godism is next to elitism. Guess who is here? Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hello, hero.
Holy, holy, JB. I was going to take a break tonight so everybody would miss me. Plus, I've been terribly busy choreographing a new ballet based on the poems of Mao Zedong and training my racing poodles. But my conscientiousness prevailed, so here I am with your weekly dose of vinyl stimulation. Tonight, two of the best. The latest by New Order called Temptation. By the way, how come 2 weeks ago everyone overlooked the second anniversary of Ian Curtis's departure from this world? Or is it that absence makes the heart grow forgetful? But to begin, the new one from China Crisis, the up-and-coming Liverpool band whose first single I unveiled to the world here several months back. This is called Scream Down at Me.
Thank you.
Beach had a crisis. Screamed down at me. The Alita set from courtesy of Harrow. Both were the 12-inch versions as opposed to the 7.
Why settle for 7 when you can have 12?
Yeah, exactly. That's what we've always said here. Saturday night, hour number 2, Neon, program 114, and clear skies over Saskatchewan tonight. Look, see, hear the tritons testing above. Say hello, wave goodbye. There is a place. Hello there in North Ontario. They can't get any stereo. We've got a captive audience. Hello, Hamilton, Thunder Bay, one of our favorite places, and all the swell guys and gals on the shores of Lake Inferior. But I think I'll go out to Alberta. There's a lot.
Calgary.
It's about time that we acknowledged the financial capital of Mother Canuck. More specifically, a gentleman scribe, Mr. Tibby, was who brought to our attention an appearance in May of 1979 in that fair city, in the downtown mall by the hot dog stand, of one university-trained street saxophone player performing a version of Summertime. His last name was and is Leonard, and he is now known as John Boy Leonard, sax player for Theater of Hate. Better in my life, Hex Induction Hour, the classical, the fall. Insects, lock the key and throw away the door. Insects from Vancouver, three-song EP, Theater of Hate from their Westworld EP, and Propaganda. It is time to creep and crawl into the darkness of night steep. For Neon and everybody down here, Modern Mono from Babylon, Coover, hope that you can join us next week. We'll leave with music of Felt. Good night.
This is CBC Radio.
This is Charlie Ferguson telling you this is the year for us to get it all together. I'm talking about your fellowship. Now, I know you can't love everybody. Nobody's asking you to, but some people just loves to hate everybody in bunches. Listen, take people one at a time and judge them by their individual selves, not where they come from or who they look like. That's facial discrimination. During Brotherhood Year, all us brother and sisterhood should get our fellowship together.
Here is the CBC News. The impending British assault on the Argentinian garrison in Port Stanley is coming closer as the fog that has enveloped the Falkland Islands for the past few days starts to lift. During the waiting period, the British assault force has been preparing for an intensive bombardment of the Argentine positions, but hope has been expressed that this may not be necessary in consideration of the estimated 500 islanders who are still in the capital. In Buenos Aires, the Argentine command says its artillery has been pounding the British positions around Port Stanley. But British reporters on the spot say the artillery attack has been ineffective. In London, the Falkland Islands office has started a drive to raise funds to help the islanders rebuild their lives after the Argentinians depart. Reports from the Middle East say that Israeli tanks have crossed the frontier and are rolling into southern Lebanon. The invasion follows a day of unprecedented bombing of suspected Palestinian bases in Lebanon. Wave after wave of Israeli warplanes maintained a 10-hour assault, hitting not only at PLO bases, but also at highways, rail lines, bridges, and communications lines in order to hamper PLO activities. The aerial bombardment was supported by the shelling of coastal positions from the sea and by artillery barrages on targets in southern Lebanon. The Israeli strike follows an attack on the Israeli ambassador in London, which left him critically wounded. British police have arrested three Arabs on charges of attempted murder. At the economic summit at Versailles, President Reagan has refused to give in to demands that the United States interest rates be lowered. Prime Minister Trudeau was among the leaders who said that the high level of interest rates in the United States is harming the economies of other nations. President Reagan, however, promised to take steps to keep the U.S. dollar stable in exchange for promises of restrictions on granting trade credits to Moscow. This is part of an attempted economic squeeze on the Soviet Union, which comes at a time when Moscow is attempting to buy Canadian grain on credit. In Calgary, Ian McLeod reports.
The Canadian Wheat Board sold $4.5 billion worth of grain last year and hopes to surpass that this year. Soviets, our most important customers, have had poor harvests, but they do have the luxury of choice among competing suppliers. The Winnipeg-based president of a major grain company, Cargill, says the Soviets have asked Argentina and Europe for low-interest credit terms. Now, says Roger Murray, they're asking Canada.
It's being negotiated right now. Some of that type of problem. We're changing in our dealings with the Soviet Union from being a total cash to more of a credit.
The Wheat Board has had to balance the chance of increased grain sales against the credit risk. One economist, Kurt von den Hagen of the Royal Bank, says private lenders are increasingly wary of the Soviet bloc. He says it's not clear if there's room for interest payments in the centrally planned economies. Mr. Murray says junior partners like Poland and Romania are already defaulting on loans.
If this becomes a treadmill, which goes round faster and faster and faster, then eventually there could be a potential time when you have to pull out, but I don't think that's happened yet.
The Wheat Board won't discuss the talks with the Soviets, but they say the Wheat Board won't get into a cutthroat credit war with other grain suppliers unless there's political interference from Ottawa. Ian McLeod, CBC News, Calgary.
Several thousand demonstrators marched through Paris today, protesting against the nuclear arms race and against U.S. policies in Central America. When the crowd started smashing windows and throwing gasoline bombs, the police moved in to disperse them. No arrests were made. A radiant Sophia Loren was cheered by scores of admirers today when she emerged from a women's prison near Naples after serving 17 days of a 30-day prison sentence. The sentence was for tax evasion. Miss Loren, accompanied by her lawyer, drove away in a silver Mercedes bound for her mother's apartment in Rome. She said that in spite of her prison sentence, she was happy to be back in Italy among her family and friends. And that's the news from the CBC News Service. Here's the Ontario regional. First for Metro Toronto, periods of rain overnight with a low near 12, the rain ending Sunday morning, sunny periods developing Sunday afternoon, high near 19, outlook for Monday, mainly sunny, not as cool. For Lake St. Clair, Lake Erie, Southern Lake Huron regions, including Windsor, London, and Kitchener, rain ending overnight, gradual clearing Sunday afternoon, lows tonight 10 to 13, highs Sunday near 20. Outlook for Monday warmer with a chance of a shower late in the day. For Niagara and Western Lake Ontario regions, including Hamilton, periods of rain overnight, lows 10 to 13, rain ending Sunday morning, sunny breaks developing Sunday afternoon, highs near 19. Outlook for Monday, mainly sunny, not so cool. For southern Haliburton, eastern Lake Ontario regions, and Peterborough, periods of rain overnight, lows around 12. Cloudy tomorrow with rain ending during the afternoon, continuing cool with highs near 18. Outlook for Monday, mainly sunny, not so cool. For northern Lake Huron, southern Georgian Bay regions, rain ending overnight, lows 8 to 10. Sunday cloudy in the morning, followed by partial clearing during the afternoon, highs 18 to 20. The outlook for Monday, mainly sunny, not so cool. For northern Georgian Bay, northern Haliburton regions, and the cities of North Bay and Sudbury, partly cloudy overnight with lows 7 to 9. Sunny on Sunday with cloudy periods, highs 20 to 23. Outlook for Monday, windy with chance of showers late in the day. For Rainy Lake, Sioux Lookout, and Atikokan, a few clouds overnight, lows 7 to 9, mainly sunny tomorrow with afternoon cloudy periods. Occasional showers or thundershowers by evening. Brisk southerly winds, highs 23 to 25. The outlook for Monday, showers and turning cooler. For Nipigon and Thunder Bay, a few clouds overnight, lows 7 to 9, mainly sunny tomorrow, a few afternoon cloudy periods, brisk southerly winds, and highs near 26. The outlook for Monday, showers and turning cooler. For Algoma, Southern White River, Tomogamy, Cochrane, Moose River regions, including Sault Ste. Marie, a few clouds overnight, lows 4 to 7, continuing mainly sunny and warm tomorrow, highs 21 to 24, but cooler near Lake Superior. Outlook for Monday, windy with a few showers developing. For Geraldton, Northern White River, and Southern Winisk regions, mostly clear overnight, lows 6 to 9. Sunday, windy, continuing warm, increasing afternoon cloudiness, risk of an evening thunderstorm. Highs 21 to 24, but cooler near Lake Superior. The outlook for Monday, windy with showers. For Northern Winisk, mostly cloudy with isolated showers overnight, lows around 5. Windy and warmer Sunday with a few showers developing later in the afternoon, highs near 20. Outlook for Monday, windy with a few showers. For Whiteshell Kenora, including Lake of the Woods, small craft warning issued, wind south 40 kilometers an hour this evening, diminishing overnight, mainly cloudy with occasional showers or thundershowers during the night, lows 10 to 12. Tomorrow, cloudy with showers and isolated thundershowers developing by afternoon, highs around 24. The outlook for Monday, showers and turning cooler. For Red Lake and Favorable Lake, mainly cloudy with occasional showers or thundershowers overnight, moderate southerly winds diminishing, and lows 10 to 12. Cloudy with showers on Sunday, isolated thundershowers developing by afternoon, brisk southerly winds, highs 21 to 24. The outlook for Monday, showers and turning cooler. For Pickle Lake, a few clouds overnight, lows around 10, mainly sunny tomorrow with a few afternoon cloudy periods and brisk southerly winds, highs around 24. The outlook for Monday, showers and turning cooler. For Severn River, mainly cloudy overnight, lows 8 to 10, mainly cloudy tomorrow with showers developing by afternoon, highs around 18. And the outlook for Monday, showers and turning cooler. And that's the Ontario weather. CBL now concludes its broadcast day. Owned and operated by the Canadian Broadcasting Corporation, CBL is located in Toronto, Ontario, Canada, and transmits on an assigned frequency of 740 kilohertz with a power of 50,000 watts. We invite you to join us at 6 o'clock this morning for CBL's unique brand of early morning radio. Good night.